Hello students, welcome to the money banking. Today we are going to talk about retail banking from money and banking subject of BCom first year second semester. Now before we get into what is retail banking, let us look at what is a bank. Generally, a bank is a financial institution which is taking the deposits, accepting the deposits from the people which has surplus in money and channeling the same thing or same money to the needy parties. Who are the needy parties? The needy parties can be individuals or it can be businesses or business houses. So, this can be the channelizing of money can be directly or indirectly happening. What is directly? If the business houses are taking loans directly from the bank, it is channeling directly to the needy people. By contrast, if the money is channeled through the capital markets, particularly the equity markets and sometimes the debt markets, it is indirect way of channeling the excess money. For example, if you look at the bank's financial resources, it accepts the deposits in the short term and in the long term. And it extends the loans for the short term and the long term. So, the bank's financial resources or liabilities from where the money is being raised, it is a resource which is a liability for the bank, and where it is advancing, where it is giving its money, this money which is raised, is the asset. The long term loans are the long term assets. The long term loans that it has advanced is a long term asset. The short term loans that it has advanced is a short term asset. So, a bank's balance sheet has assets and liabilities. Assets are all deposits and liabilities are all the loans that it advances. So, it is the connection between, a bank is a connection between the customers that have capital deficits and the customers with the capital surplus. The customers with the money deficit and the customers with the money surplus. Thus, the core activity of a bank is the intermediary. It is acting as intermediary between the deposits holders and the borrowers. Now, let us look at a banking system, how it looks. It provides safe place to save the excess cash known as deposits. As I told you, it takes the deposits, it accepts the deposits. So, it is a safe place to keep your excess money. Now, this money that is collected by the bank supplies the liquidity to the economy by loaning this money to help the business to grow, either as I told you, individually or in corporates. It can be directly or it can be indirectly. Directly in the sense, you are advancing money directly to the corporates. Indirectly, you are advancing, you are investing the money through the capital markets, and from there the companies will be raising the money. So, it allows consumers to purchase, and the next thing is, it is also allowing the consumers to purchase consumer products and homes and cars, etc. Now, if you go to any electronic showroom, you will find a couple of tables with the financials. It can be Bajaj Finserv, or it can be IDFC Bank, or it can be HDFC Bank, it can be ICICI Bank. So, who are these people sitting in the electronic stores? They are all the bankers who want to meet the financial needs for the consumer durables. Sometimes, you may come across some tables or kiosks where the banks render the services of advancing the home loans. And you will be surprised to know at you know, in the airports also, in the big malls also, you know, by just taking your Aadhaar card and by taking your KYC documents, know your customer documents, they will instantly advance the loans by checking the credit scores at the CIBIL. So this is how the banks operate. Now we can understand the bank functions are broadly three types: the retail banking, the corporate banking, and the wholesale banking. Now, before we look into retail banking, what is a corporate banking we will look at, because we are going to discuss retail banking in detail. Let us look at the corporate banking first, then continue with the wholesale banking and come to retail banking. Now, what is a corporate banking? So this is a division of a bank that mostly deals with the deposits and loans from the corporations or large businesses. And this corporate banking is generally, it will not deal with the individuals. It doesn't deal with the retail consumers or customers. It deals with the huge industrial undertakings. Sometimes some banks may fix the lending quote, lending limit from 1 crore and above only. This branch will give the loan for a minimum of 1 crore or so. Some banks may say, we will give a loan of minimum of 10 crores. So these banks will not lend loans to the individuals. They lend loans to only the corporate houses. So similarly, they also accept the deposits from the corporates. So the dealing is with the corporate, not with the individuals. Now let us come to wholesale banking. Banking service between the merchant banks and other financial institutions. So it deals with the larger institutions, and some services might include currency conversion, working capital finance, and large trade transactions. Now you may come across some banks may be falling short of the balances, so they may deal with the other banks for the interbank adjustments. Now sometimes you may come across the financial needs of the working capital of the company. Now let us have a look at what's a working capital. Working capital is the short-term need of the company. What is there included in the working capital? Now the needs of the current assets. What are the current assets? The stock required to produce, and the material that is required. Stock is the stock of material we call. The stock can be the raw material to be procured, and the manpower to be employed, the production expenses to be met. So all these things are the working capital. So these working capital needs are met by the financial institutions. So generally, till 1960s, it was the financial institutions which were meeting the needs of the corporates, but later on, the commercial banks, the banks in general, they began setting up a separate branch only for meeting the wholesale needs of the industry, that is large-scale needs of the industry. Now look at the retail banking. A retail banking is when the bank executes transactions directly with the customers rather than corporations or other banks. Now in the previous two formats of the banks, they are dealing with the other banks. They are dealing with the corporates. They are not dealing with the individuals. But in the third category of retail banking, they are directly dealing with the customers. So it is a consumer banking, we can say. A retail banking is a consumer banking. Now before we further get into retail banking, let us understand what is a merchant bank or investment bank. A merchant bank is a financial institution which provides capital to the companies in the form of share ownership instead of loans. Now look at this. They will subscribe for the shares of the corporates rather than advancing the loan. When it is advanced as a loan, what is the problem? There is a point called repayment. If there's a tenure decided by the bank, the loan of 10 years, so after 10 years, the amount has to be recollected back from the corporate to whom you are giving the money. So when it is a merchant bank or an investment bank, you need not collect back that money because you are subscribing to the shares of the company. Like many other investors, you are also an investor. So there may be some retail investors and you are an investment bank, you are a merchant bank, you are a large scale investor. Rather, you are called as an institutional investor. So, what is happening? You will be becoming the owner of the bank along with many, many hundreds of the customers in case of a merchant bank. So, it provides advisory services on the corporate matters to the firm if they are investing rather than advancing loans. Now, in the United Kingdom, the historical term for merchant bank is investment bank, as I told you. The synonym for the merchant bank is investment bank. Now, to conclude this, what is merchant banking? It is simply subscribing to the shares of the corporates rather than advancing the loan. And these shares can be sold in the market whenever the merchant banker is in need of the funds. Now, let us understand the retail banking. You might have understood the difference by now. What is the difference between the retail banking and the investment banking and the wholesale banking and the corporate banking? So, I want you to understand the difference between mainly between the investment bank and a retail bank. An investment bank and a retail bank. An investment bank is dealing with the corporate, whereas the retail banking is dealing with the consumer, the customer. The investment bank is dealing with the corporate, while the retail bank is dealing with the consumer or customer. Now, retail bank, as I told you, refers to the banking in which they execute the transactions directly with the consumers. Okay, so let us look at the products of the retail banking, how the retail banking looks like. Now, you can see the saving and transaction accounts, and you can see the mortgage loans, you can see the personal loans, you can see the debit cards, you can see the credit cards, and you can see the internet banking, you can see the ATM cards, and there are plethora of the retail banking products you can see. So these days, the advent of technology made the lives of the customers easy. Now, people need not go to the bank branches physically to transact with the banks. They can anywhere, even from their mobile phones or the cellular phones, they can operate their transactions. They can transfer the money, they can withdraw the money, they can deposit the money from one account to another account without being physically visiting the branch. So all these facilities are there in the internet banking, and you can also do it in the mobile phones through an application or the app. Okay, now today's retail banking, if we look at it, has three-tier characteristic. I mean to say, the retail banking structure is based on three-tier characteristics. What are they? The deposits, credit cards, insurance, investments, and securities. These are the products of the retail banks. Come again. What are the products of the retail bank? You have debit cards, you have credit cards, you have internet banking, you have ATM cards, you have traveler's checks, you have certificate of deposits, you have also the mutual fund investments. These are all the products of the retail banks. So the second tier is the channels of distribution in retail banking. What are the channels? You can deal through the call center. When you want to transact in through your account or about your account or in your account, you need not visit the bank physically, as I told you earlier. You can take your mobile phone, call to the call center. The executive to whom you have never seen can help you, can assist you in transferring of the funds, or in verifying your data with related to the deposits and the withdrawals, and he can assist you with all details of your banks. So there's a call center that is, you know, you are not meeting each other. The customer and the banker are not physically meeting. It is that there's a technological medium which is helping these two parties. Technology face acts as an interface. And there is a branch. Physically, you can visit the bank and you can transact, you can talk to them, you can deposit money, you can withdraw the money, you can verify about your balance, you can verify about the number of checks that are issued, you can verify the number of withdrawals in a given period of time. So all these things you can verify with the executive sitting at the branch desk. Now, thirdly, you can have internet banking. So internet banking is, you know, the facility given by the technology, as I told you. So call center, you can pick up your phone and call and deal with your your account, or you can visit physically, secondly. And thirdly, you can open your computer, log on to your account through by giving or providing your credentials, and then you can verify what all is happening about your account. So this is channel distribution. Second one is channel distribution. First one is the products in the retail banking. Now let us come to the customer groups. Who are the groups in the retail banking? Now there are consumers, there are small businesses, and there are corporates. Now sometimes corporates also are trying to use some small amounts of the products whenever they are in need, that whenever they feel that this product can be useful to them, they may be using. So the banks in retail banking segment in particular, there are three types of groups, customer groups, that is direct consumer, small businesses, and corporates. So the gamut of retail banking can be understood in three-tier structure. There are products, there are channels, and there are groups. Let me tell you once again, there are products in the retail banking, there are channels in the retail banking, and there are customer groups in the retail banking. Now, let us understand what has contributed to retail banking. Why the retail banking has become very popular across the globe. Now, in India, it has becoming for the last 10 years, it has become very famous. Now, if you look at the youth, they are not visiting the branch. It is very long. Maybe a person may be working in an IT company, but it is very rarely they are visiting the branch unless there is a very severe problem, or if the branch is just nearby, they are not visiting the branches. Everything is done virtually by either using the internet on their laptop or by using their mobile phone application. So what contributed to this buzz? Economy prosperity and increase in the purchasing power led to the consumer boom. I think you will agree with me. The income levels have increased because of the openness of the markets. The globe has become village. The globe is shrinking and the companies are investing. The capitals are flowing. And with this, the productivity is increasing, the employment levels are increasing, then the purchasing power is increasing. This is one reason we can attribute to. Another reason could be changing consumer demographics. Changing consumer demographics. Now, the people who are under the age of 35 in India are 70%. Let me come again. 70% of the Indian population is below 35 years of age. Now look at this. This group are more interested in using the technology for their conveniences rather than the senior people or people who are at 40s and 50s visiting the branches and dealing with their bank accounts. Now technological advancement. Now, innovations in the technology, you know, resulting in the buzz or the boom in the retail banking sector. Lastly, lowering of treasury income of the banks. So these are the four factors which I feel contributed to the boom of the retail banking. Now, what's the scope of retail banking? All round increase in the economic activity, increase in the purchasing power. Rural areas have the large purchasing power at their disposal. This is an opportunity to market retail banking. Now, more than 90% of the savings come from the household sector in the retail banking. Now, 400 million middle class population is there in India and 200 million households are there in India. If the banks can tap this opportunity, and I think earlier I was telling you that the industrial houses under the wholesale banking system are giving huge amounts of profits, under retail banking now with the opportunities that we have seen can give us or can give the banks a major boost in enhancing the profit revenue and the profit. Now let me continue with the current scenario in the bank. India compares pretty poorly with the other economies of the world, now becoming comparable in terms of spending patterns. Now our income levels, the Indian income levels, are increasing, and we are also opening up our economy to the rest of the world. Thereby, the capital is flowing, our purchasing power is increasing. Retail loans in Taiwan, yet I can say the retail loans in Taiwan are about 41%, but in India it is still 5%. Now there is a need. I told you 70% of the Indian population is under 35. If we can tap that, this 5% of the retail in banking business in India can go up to 50% in no time. Now, opportunities in the retail sectors, increasing purchasing power, I told you, and the rising Indian middle class. So, let me also just present briefly what are the drivers of this retail business in India. I told you, and I just would like to sum up, the rising purchasing power, the technological advancement, and the changing scenario and the demographics in the country. Now, finally, there is a need of constant innovation in retail banking, in bracing for tomorrow. A paradigm shift in bank financing through innovative products and mechanism involving constant upgradation and revalidation of the bank's internal system and processes is inevitable. Now, banks now need to use the retail as a growth engine and trigger, and this requires product development and differentiation and innovation and business process re-engineering, micro planning, marketing, prudent pricing, customization, technological upgradation will reduce the cost, and cross-selling will also enhance the profitability of the banks. Thank you.